Hi everyone, I really enjoy making these videos, but one of the great benefits on the side is knowing that maybe I could inspire somebody in some way, whether it's inspire them to collect records in the first place, or maybe get them interested in the Beatles a little more than they have been previously, or in some way maybe giving them a laugh or something to look forward to if they're having a rough day. I mean, it's all the very same kind of thing that I actually have experienced. I mean, it's from watching videos here on YouTube by other people before I started that made me want to join and made me want to collect more than I had been and so on. So I know what it feels like, and I'm the same way. You know, life's tough enough. We like to come here and maybe go on and watch somebody's video, a person we're subscribed to that gives us a little lift now and then when we need it. So I really appreciate that, knowing that I could give that to somebody. And I appreciate when people out there, tell me that in some way I've made some kind of even a small difference. And that's the purpose of this video. I want to acknowledge three of my fans out there, people who watch my videos. And from time to time, if I'm out and about, I'll run into some people who recognize me from my channel. And this happens a lot at the Fest for Beatles fans and the record stores and things like that. And I love when they say, hey, you know, you mean Mr. Mayo, you know, I enjoy watching your videos, and they introduce themselves, and you know, I always thank them, and it means a lot to me. So I want you to know out there, anybody, if you ever happen to see me in your travels and you want to introduce yourself, please, by all means, be sure to do that. Don't feel embarrassed or like you're somehow intruding on me or something like that, because I know there was one time I was at a Paul McCartney concert, and someone later told me in the comment section here that they'd seen me and recognized me, but they didn't want to disturb me, which, believe me, I'm just a guy, you know, just like anybody else, and I'm no big star, and I really would love to say hello to you. And if you'd like, I'd like to even make a little video where we can say hello here, and I could put it on my channel if you want. I leave that up to your discretion. Just let me know. Don't feel ever like you're, you know, somehow bothering me or anything. So this particular video here has to do with two people that I met in my store, a record store. They were there shopping, and I happened to be there, and it was great to be able to say hello to them. It was actually a father and a son, and they both share the same name. And, well, here's a little snippet of our meeting. Okay, here we are at the record store. We got some Beatle fans, I see, who watch the channel, right?
Yeah.
Hey, nice to meet you. Say hello.
Hi.
And I forgot your name already.
Rodney.
Ah, good to meet you. And you are?
I'm Rodney as well.
Oh, okay, Rodney. Two Rodneys for one. I tell you, it ain't easy being me. Rodney Dangerfield. Anyway, you guys watch the channel like the Beatles, huh?
That's right.
And you guys come from Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. It's nice to see us here. Well, I appreciate your support. Enjoy the channel.
Thank you.
You know, I have to tell you that the younger Rodney, Rodney Jr., if you will, what a bright young man he is. And it's amazing how he remembered so many things about videos he's seen on my channel that I didn't even remember. And I thought it was kind of funny when I started out making that little bit of video that you saw there. He said to me, hey, be sure that you know, clean the microphone out because you have problems with your sound, you said, which is true. I almost forgot before I made this video to clean the mic out, and I did, but I hope it made a difference, because sometimes the sound goes in and out or back and forth, and I know it drives people crazy when they watch on certain devices. And well, Rodney Jr. remembered that, and he told me, make sure you take care of that, and I had to clean it out, so I would have forgotten otherwise. So it's just amazing, and I really enjoyed meeting Rodney and his dad. It's funny, you know, we must have talked for like 30 minutes at least in the record shop, and yet when the camera's on, even I myself get shy, and I don't know what there is to say when the camera's running. Too bad we didn't record the whole conversation, but at least we got a bit of it down there for posterity, if you will. So it was good meeting you two, Rodney guys. I also want to say hello to a fan that's been watching me for years. She's a woman who lives in England, and her name is Julie. And if you look back, oh, I don't know if it's a couple of years now, I made a video called Hello to Julie. This is a fan of mine who, as I say, lives in England, and she doesn't have videos that she makes, and she doesn't comment in the comments section. What she does is she writes me letters, And I think so far I've gotten 3 letters, if I counted right, maybe 4, but I think 3. And I was at my record store, and that's where she emails them. She sends them to the record store under my care, and I get them there. And I really appreciate it. I'm going to talk a little bit about, I'll show you footage of the record store. But it's funny, she actually was nice enough to send me a record album this time. And we'll get into that a little bit more after this clip. And it's funny because, you know, Joe, the record store owner, was kind of like toying with me as he often does. At first, I didn't realize the record was for me. He tried to make it like he was going to pass it off to Don, you know, the little guy who hangs out there from time to time. And at first, I didn't catch on that this was Julie, you know, a record from Julie. And, well, you see how it played out.
Here's a Beatle record.
You're bringing my rights to the private
show. Don, you want this as a present?
Hey, I want that.
What one's that, Beatles?
I'm Paul Beatles, here we go.
I'm into the Beatles shit.
Well, no, you like the girls. It's a nice lady.
No, what fucking girl was her body?
And I'll hold this for you.
I actually want that one.
No, he's getting this. He's got the money.
What is that about?
Beatles songs.
It's Beatles.
Who does it?
You have no idea what this is.
I can't see right. Let me see what that is.
Says,
play the music of John.
Swings for Pleasure. Play the music of John.
Yeah, I don't have that in my collection.
The music of.
So you need this, right?
Yeah, I need it.
You need this?
Sure.
It's a present.
Okay, thanks.
There's a card in there and a letter.
Thank you. I got it as a gift.
That's a gift.
This is a TV show?
Yeah.
You know something, folks. A package came in here to the store one day, and I'm starting to put two and two together, and I'm thinking this is from... I forget her name. Julie. That's what I think. Julie, who watches my channel. This is like VCLT, Vinyl Community Love Train.
You know the channel. You have connections.
Let's see if I'm right. Ah, there it is, sure enough. Dear Joe, wishing you health and happiness. Best wishes. God bless, Julie. Now that's nice. Is that nice?
Yeah.
Very nice of her. Thank you, Julie. Oh, there's a nice letter, too. Well, I haven't gotten one in a while, so I'm really happy to get one from you, Julie. Makes me feel good. And this is evidently a gift. And it's on the UK label. Music for Pleasure.
But that doesn't really be the singer.
No.
Somebody imitating.
That's very nice of you, Julie.
So, again, thank you so much, Julie. I mean, you don't have to send me a gift. Really, it was unnecessary, but I'm glad you did. Okay, anyway, send some more. It's fine, you know. No, so, anyway, I really appreciate it. And, you know, I didn't pick up on it right away. We just saw the video, but once I saw that there was a letter in there in this card, I kind of realized, oh, that's probably from Julie of the UK. And here it is. Better look at it here. Strings for Pleasure. Play the music of John, Paul, George, and Ringo. It's on the Music for Pleasure label from the UK. And I don't have this, at least I don't think I do, and it's much appreciated. There's solo songs on here and some Beatles songs. So thank you so much, Julie. Now, you know, Julie sends me this wonderful card, and I'm not going to read all of her letter. But it's really nice of her to send me this detailed letter. She's got so much to say. But what I really like is, it's funny, you know, at the beginning of each year, I've been making a Q&A where I have people ask me questions. And I think that was the video where I said, well, it says it here. I recently, it says, Dear Joe, within it, it says, I recently watched the video you made, especially for your viewers who sent you questions. And said how much they enjoyed watching you. And you wondered if I still was watching you. Which I was wondering because I hadn't heard from her in a while. And she writes, of course I am. She says, I've been watching your videos for years now, Joe. I am always looking to see if you have posted anything new. And you will be really chuffed to know that you have converted me. And I really like that saying, chuffed. You know, that's an English expression, and the Beatles even said that in one of their Christmas messages. You know, this time last year, we were all dead chuffed because Love Me Do had gotten into the top 20. Well, I got to tell you, I'm really dead chuffed, Julie, at, you know, this whole letter and the gift. Then she goes on to say, just a little bit I want to read here. She says, I now own 6 Beatles albums. So she wasn't really a Beatles person. And she watches my videos anyway, which is pretty amazing to me. She says, I now own 6 Beatles albums, 2 Ringo Starr albums, and 2 from Wings. And she says, I heard that gasp and saw that smile, Joe. And yes, when I first read this, I did kind of gasp and smile. She's right. Says, yep, you have made such an impression, I had to take a chance. And so last year, I bought, for starters, the Red and the Blue albums. That's the Beatles 2 compilations. I bought them from eBay and got them for £13.50, it looks like, for the 2. I was blown away, she says, when I took the time to sit and listen to the Red album. Practically every song was a feel-good song, she says, and the musicianship just left me with my chin on the floor. Wow. She writes, the Blue album did not have the same effect as the first for now. I'm not quite sure if I like the psychedelic era they went through, but I will keep playing the records and give them the time to get under my skin, as it were. Then she just says, I then bought new copies of A Hard Day's Night, Abbey Road, and Sgt. Pepper's, plus a dodgy live album. The other albums I bought are secondhand London Town, which is McCartney's album, and Speed of Sound, and Ringo, Time Takes Time, she says, which is the new one. Well, it's not really the new one, but it's really a great album, and it was come out in 1992, Julie, and Ringo since then has had quite a few, maybe 6 or 7 albums since then, so it's not the newest. And she says that she's on the lookout for John Lennon, and I really want a copy of George Harrison's Living in the Material World. I have to say thanks, Joe, for your passion for the band and the fact that it has, after many years, given me a new ear to listen to the Beatles. So that's pretty incredible to me. I don't know how old Julie is exactly, but I know that in the letters, I think she said she's an 80s person. She grew up with the 80s music, I think. So it gives us some idea. Julie, thanks so much. I can't tell you how much it means to me. What more can I say? You know, the gift, the letter, the thoughts. It's amazing to me, and Julie's not the only one who's told me that. They're not really big Beatles fans, but yet for some reason, when they watch me with my passion, they say, and my interest, and how much I get into this, that it makes them interested in the Beatles somehow, and they want to check them out. I just find that amazing. Like, I would think of so many of my videos are all Beatles. You would think that if you don't like the Beatles, why bother watching? But a lot of people have said they watch anyway. So that's pretty amazing. Well, that's it for now. Thanks again to the 2 Rodneys, Rodney Sr. and Rodney Jr. Thank you, Julie. And again, like I said, you know, anybody ever recognizes me out there, wants to say hello, please don't feel shy. You know, I'm shy too, believe it or not. You know, and, you know, if you want to say hello, please do. And, you know, see if you want to make a little video. Maybe you could be on and say hello on the channel or something like that. So anyway, thanks everybody for watching, and have a great weekend and week ahead. Thank you.